Welcome to Module 4 of the 6 Essential Lessons of an E-commerce Business, Managing an E-commerce Business. We're now going to talk about fraud and security. These are two big deals when it comes to a marketing or an online business. Fraud is something that is pervasive, and security is something for which we're all now responsible. In fact, some of the highest amount of expenditures people have in the e-commerce business, depending on the sensitivity of data that they're using, they may have to spend that money in the fraud and security management area. We are all familiar with, at least people who are in the investment and management side of an e-commerce business, with this thing called phishing. Phishing is where, phishing spelled with a PH instead of an F, is where people would send you emails, and in these emails, they're going to ask you to click on something. Why is that a big deal for us? We just spoke about a module in marketing where that's your bread and butter in terms of pay-per-click advertising. Someone goes to a website or to a marketing piece in an email marketing campaign, and they're going to click on a link, and based on clicking on that link, you're expecting to make the money in your e-commerce business. Something now goes wrong when phishing comes into the picture, because phishing is where we now have fraud on top of your business. So fraud and phishing, as you can see on this slide, is the dark side of e-commerce, where people can add in places that you can click on an ad that on an email or an ad that appears to be perfectly fine, but in the end and towards the background, there are things going on in there that's going to be terrible, because they're going to bring either some kind of a financial loss or the theft of people's information. Online security, it's one of those things that we say in the e-commerce space that nobody's going to claim responsibility for it. So therefore, it falls on all of us. There are some parts to secured online business that we should at least know what they are, and we don't need to become subject area experts in them, but we should at least know what they are. They are secure web browsing, site object encryption and decryption, proxy servers, IP addresses, web tracking cookies, and this thing called quiet malware. To begin with, when we talk about a secure website, there is a way to tell if you're on a secure website or not. And that is, if you look in the URL or the universal resource locator of a website, that's the unique name of a website, the very beginning protocols should have an HTTP with an S. HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocols, and with an S means it is now secured. If you go to a website where you are expecting to put in your personal data, put in something that even resembles credit card information, if that website does not have a hypertext transfer protocol S for secured, you probably don't want to touch that. In more modern browsing, you would, instead of seeing that HTTPS to be secured, you will see a literal lock, where the lock is open or the lock is closed, locked, meaning that you are in a secure transfer protocol area. The next thing is IP addresses and the capturing of IP addresses. Now, how this works is once you go online to somebody's website, your IP address is captured. So your side is now locked down. Your IP address is now peered with the IP address of the site you're going to. Between those two sites, nothing should come between them, and therefore you now have something called end-to-end encryption. End-to-end encryption means from your IP address to the IP address of your host, that is encrypted, and anything that goes back and forth can be seen by no one else, but more importantly, the message can be scrambled up on one end, sent to the other end, and the other end now has a decryption piece to it that unscrambles what was sent over. Therefore, no one should be able to get in between these two IP addresses to create some sort of fraud. Now, this is modern, new technology, and it does cost money. And therefore, my suggestion is if you're going to be having an e-commerce business, I suggest that you invest in secure shell servers where you know for a fact that you've got encrypted and decrypted messages going between the two IP addresses that are communicating. There is also something called cookies. Cookies is a way that two places communicate with each other. For example, the first time that I use my Wells Fargo account or I use my Bank of America account online or I use my SunTrust account online, the SunTrust server is going to create a cookie that it puts on my computer. That cookie allows them to tell that I am the person trying to get to their server. If that cookie stays in place, those two servers or those two users, you as a user and the service provider as the bank, can identify each other a lot faster. So cookies are used to speed up the process of identifying who that person is knocking on the door of my server. The thing about cookies is that it is a separate little piece of information written on your local hard drive. And anything that's written on your local hard drive is in and of itself a security risk, because it means that somebody has some kind of encrypted software that can access that cookie and communicate between those two units. Now, as an e-commerce business person, you're probably not going to become a subject area expert on cookies and proxy servers and decryption and encryption. You will most likely outsource that to a security expert, somebody who's going to be either working in your business as a security expert or someone to whom you're going to outsource that function in the security business. Now, merchants are targets, as are individuals. One of the ways that people get hacked, to use a term that's used out there a lot, is through something called a proxy server. A proxy server is where a person uses a computer and they bounce that computer off of another computer located somewhere else out there on planet Earth. That server out there is what's going to communicate with you. So if you're going to somebody's website and that person is going to bounce you to a proxy server, you need to have security in place to tell you, hey, the certificate of the server that you are trying to use does not match up with the certificate of the server that you're bouncing off of. Do you want to proceed? Many times you may have seen this when you've done something online and you are asked, do you want to proceed or not? One of the ways that servers can tell if it's the same or if it's a proxy is by the date stamp. If you're going to a server that says it is 2:45 p.m. Eastern time right now, and the next thing you know is you're on a server that says it is 5:45 p.m. Pacific time, suddenly the certificates don't match up, and that's a way for us to tell that we are looking at a proxy server. And if you look at this slide, it shows how the bad guys are getting smarter and smarter every day in terms of how they make a server look like it is what you think it is. So with that, we've now looked at the different security and fraud risks that you have to be aware of. And please, if you're going to invest in something to make your business secure, invest in some sort of a software that is going to lock down your servers, especially if you're dealing with sensitive information, including payment information. If you're doing payments online, you want that information to be as secure as possible. And if you have to invest a couple of extra bucks, please ensure that you invest that couple of extra bucks in your fraud and security management system. So it's a fairly short area of discussion, but very important. We hope you got some good information from this section, and we will look forward to seeing you in our next section.